Hey, what's up, guys? Hey, I came across some new tires that are out there in the market, and I also wanted to make a note about some tubes stuff here. First up is Motos, or Moto Z tubes. I call them Motos. I've been using these, and they are pretty cool tubes because they're made out of all-natural rubber instead of butyl rubber, like regular tubes are, which means they will stretch more without developing like a fissure in them. They also, if you should have to patch them, natural rubber will take a patch a lot easier than butyl rubber will. These tubes are also slightly oversized, so when you fill them up with air, they're not stressed. Like a cheap tube made out of a thinner butyl rubber, when you fill it up to pressure, generally, you know, it's pretty tight in there. These tubes, when you fill them up to pressure, they still have give in them, so they're not stretched to the limit, which should help eliminate pinch flats or things like that. They come in three different varieties. They have the standard, which is 1.4 millimeters thick. They have heavy duty racing, which is 3 millimeters thick. And they have the uber heavy duty, which is listed as 4 millimeters thick. I've been using the heavy duty ones in the KLX, and knock on wood, haven't got a pinch flat yet, haven't had any issues. In Little Joe, I got the standard duty, the standard duty ones in there. I think that's just because that was the only flavor that had the sizes for the little wheels. But anyways, next time you change your tubes, check them out. They're not really much more expensive, only by a few bucks maybe, than like regular cheapo tubes from somebody else. You can get them at Rocky Mountain ATV and other places. All right, next up, Shinko has a couple new tires out. What a lot of people don't know about Shinko is they actually, behind the scenes, make tires for a lot of the brand names that you might be purchasing. For example, they used to make tires for Golden Tire. So that's where they were made, in the Shinko factory. Golden Tire recently moved their production to China, and Shinko owns the molds to the tires. So Shinko decided, well, we're just going to make our own tires using the molds. And so they came out with this MX 216 series, or 216 MX. They come in 8100, 9090, and a 9100 fatty. They are exactly the same tire as the Golden Tire 216 front tires, except for they're like $30 less per tire. There's a guy in Japan who, I forget his channel name right this minute, but he's lives over there, rides enduro. So he gets his hands on this stuff pretty fast, and he has tested them up against the Golden Tires with the durometer meter and everything. They're the exact same tire. They just say Shinko on them now instead of saying Golden Tire. So that's pretty cool. If you're looking to try, wanted to try a Golden Tire 216, but maybe the cost put you off, now you can get it. They're here in the U.S. at like Slavens Racing has them. And it's like I said, $30 less than the Shinko branded one, or sorry, the Golden Tire branded one. There's only one catch though. Here's the catch. The 9100 fatty version, Golden Tire used to offer a 2-ply and a 4-ply version. The 4-ply version was a heavier tire. It weighed more. Then Golden Tire now only offers the 2-ply this year. The Shinko one is a 4-ply tire still. So it's going to be a little bit heavier tire, if that's anything to be concerned about. On the plus side, I'm running a Golden Tire 216 2-ply on the front of my bike. It's a pretty lightweight bike. I know for a fact I can run around with 8 PSI all day long. If I had the 4-ply tire, I might be able to sneak by with 6 PSI because it's going to have stiffer sidewalls on it for sure. If you have a slightly heavier bike, like a KTM 250 or 350, something like that, you could probably, with the 4-ply tire, get away with 8 PSI without issue. I've seen people with 0 PSI with a tubeless system use them, and they still didn't fully compress the tire down, like doing a stoppie. So anyways, that's the front tire news. On the rear tire front, Shinko had a tire called the 505 Cheater. And it was, or 505 Hybrid Cheater. It was kind of a trail enduro tire, but then also combined some trials tire stuff. So it had like a more close together pattern. The new tire they've come out with is the 525S Extreme Enduro. This is almost an exact duplicate of the Golden Tire 216 rear tire. That's what I'm currently running on my KLX. But Golden Tire also has an X version of that tire, which has an extremely gummy compound. They call it the gummy. It's for extreme grip in rocks and everything else like that. The Shinko one lists itself as being for intermediate to hard terrain, and the durometer rating on it is 50 to 52, which, to give you an idea, a typical intermediate terrain tire might be 60 to 70 on the durometer meter, and that's like an intermediate kind of soft compound. So this is, you know, like it says, it's a gummy type tire. So it may not last as long as a regular tire, but it should give you like shit tons more grip. And the tread pattern on this, again, is pretty much a duplicate of the Golden Tire 216 rear. Maybe even a little more aggressive tread on the sidewalls, you know, around the edges. Jeff Slavens did a review of it. He put like 200 miles on it on like extreme rocky terrains. His only comment was, if you ride severe rocks all the time, it may not, you know, last as long as another tire, but he had no complaints about the grip or the traction or anything going with it. But I'm going to say that he probably rides a lot faster and a lot more aggressively than most of us do. So he did 200 miles on it like in a weekend. For the rest of us, it's, I'm sure, going to be like a tire that would last you like all year or maybe two summers or whatever. And the cool thing is the Golden Tire version of this, which would be the 216 gummy tire, the 216X, that's like $130-some. The Shinko version of this, the 525S Extreme, is like $73. So that's quite a big price difference. So if you wanted a gummy type rear tire and the price of those tires from other brands was a deterrent, this is your opportunity to get one very inexpensively. I mean, it's price-wise, it is really actually cheaper than some brands' front tires. The Golden Tire 216 front is like $99 for the fatty. So this rear tire is, you know, $20-some cheaper than that. All right, so these rear tires, they come in 110, 100 size, and that's listed as being for 250 and 350 four-strokes and like 200, 300, whatever, two-strokes. And then they have a 120 over 90 that's listed for like 450 four-strokes and big-ass two-strokes. If I had a dual-sport type bike, I would go with the 120 over 90. And for a dirt bike or a lightweight dual-sport like the KTMs or Betas or stuff, I would probably try the 110-100 size. Now, the MX-216 or 216MX is listed as DOT right on the side of the tire. I haven't found out yet for the 525S Extreme if that's a DOT. But since it's pretty much an exact duplicate clone of the Golden Tire 216, which is DOT, I expect this one will be too. But you could just email customer service at Shinko Tire USA if that's a concern for you. Other than that, these are looking to be great tires, definitely at a bargain price. So I'm not going to call them cheap. I'm just going to call them inexpensive. But you're basically getting a set of Golden Tires for like half the cost, and you know, especially getting the Golden Tire gummy rear here on this thing. So they look pretty cool to me. I'm definitely interested in trying out the 525S rear. I'm just going to keep running my current Golden Tire front until it wears out. That's pretty much it. Take it easy.